China seems to have figured out how to make 7-nanometer chips despite the US sanction. I'm gonna give you three possible reasons or three possible ways through which SMIC may have managed to achieve this breakthrough. Before we continue, if you like what we talk about on this channel and you have not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe. Now, there has been a publication indicating that the Shanghai-based Semiconductor Manufacturing International Corporation, SMIC, has successfully been able to manufacture a 7-nanometer chip. According to a chip teardown by TechInsight, which recently bought a cryptocurrency mining machine manufactured by SMIC, noticed that it has used a 7-nanometer chip. The last time we heard of SMIC, there was a publication that SMIC was even struggling with the manufacturing of 14-nanometer chip. So with the new information that SMIC is able to manufacture 7-nanometer chip despite the US sanction, is a shocking news, and moreover, is a surprising news as well. This is happening despite the US placing huge sanction on SMIC, preventing this tech firm from obtaining lithography machines from ASML. This is a clear indication that the attempt by America to stop or slow down the rise of Chinese-based semiconductor ambition isn't working out. And this has kept people in the tech world wondering, how did SMIC achieve this? I'm gonna give you three possible reasons or three possible ways through which SMIC may have managed to achieve this breakthrough. One of the key reasons is the fact that as a result of the US sanction, China was forced to establish or pump a lot of investment towards its own local chip manufacturing market, of which SMIC has also made huge investments towards the chip manufacturing business. Even though China is still far away from achieving the 5-nanometer to 3-nanometer, this achievement by SMIC is a clear indication that these investments are gradually paying off. The second possible way by which SMIC has been able to achieve this is the fact that SMIC has been able to attract former employees from tsmc, which is currently the world top semiconductor manufacturing company based in Taiwan. The third reason why SMIC can do this is because it is possible to use old DUV machines to manufacture 7-nanometer chips. Companies such as tsmc and Samsung has equally been able to achieve this without using the most advanced DUV machines. Using old DUV machines to manufacture 7-nanometer chips come with its own challenges. One of the challenges has to do with the quality of the chip manufactured and also the cost at which it can be done. Currently, it's not clear if SMIC can go down towards the 5-nanometer chips, but SMIC being able to manufacture 7-nanometer chips even in the absence of the most advanced DUV machine is a big win for China. By the way, what do you think? Do you think SMIC could have been able to manufacture their own DUV machine despite the US sanction, or they have gotten hold of the DUV machine that can make 7-nanometer chips despite the US sanction? Kindly leave your comments and let me know what you think. And please, if you haven't subscribed, kindly do well to subscribe so we can grow this channel. Thank you so much and have a good day.